Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to work with native events of the checkbox and radio button components in a Blazor WebAssembly application. I will also show you how to perform model binding for these components and how to validate them in forms. First, I open my existing example, where I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor buttons package and written code to render the checkbox and radio button components. If you want to know how to get started with Syncfusion Blazor checkbox and radio button, check the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this example. The checkbox is rendered. I can check and uncheck it. Then, for the radio buttons, I can select either the male or female. Let me show you how to work with native events. The list of native events supported in both checkbox and radio button are on change, on focus, on input, etc. Now, we will see the on change event. In the checkbox component, I include the on change event and assign the method value changed. In value changed method, I get the state of the checkbox when checked or unchecked through a change event argument and set the value to the isChecked variable. Then in the SF checkbox tag, I append this variable to label. Check now, the checkbox label contains its current status. When I change the checkbox state, the onChange event will be triggered, and its status on the label will be updated. In the same way, I include the onChange event on both radio buttons and assign the callback method onSelect. In onSelect method, using the event argument, I assign the selected radio button label to the variable value. Then, inside the paragraph tag, I display the selected category. When I select the category, the onChange event will be triggered, and category on the paragraph will be updated. Let's now look at checkbox model binding. In this example, I'll render the checkbox and button inside a form. If you submit the form without clicking the checkbox, I want a validation message to shown. I add another row and include the edit form tag. Next, I add the content division tag and include the SF checkbox tag, followed by the label agree to terms and conditions. Then I add the SF button tag and assign the content submit. To apply validation, just use the namespace system.componentModel.dataAnnotations. Then, to add the data annotation support, I include the data annotations validator tag. I define the model class annotation with a Boolean field check and include the error message. I create an object annotate for the class annotation and assign this annotate object to the form model. Then, I add the @bindChecked property and assign the check field from the annotation class. I include the validation message tag to display the validation messages for the checkbox. Using the for property, we map the field for validation. Here, I use the check field from the annotation. Next, in the button, we add the HTML attributes property to specify the button type. In the code section, I define a submit variable of dictionary type and set the button type attribute to submit. I then assign this submit variable to the HTML attributes property. I also add the CSS class property, ealign, in the checkbox and button components. Checking now, when I submit the form without clicking the checkbox, the validation message is shown. When the box is checked, the error message disappears. Unchecking the box causes the error message to reappear. Finally, I will show you model binding in the radio button component. In the same example, I include two radio buttons, one for the UG course option and the other for the PG course. I want to show a validation message when a form is submitted with the UG course option. Include the header tag and add the class ealign. Set the caption degree. I include another field, degree, in the annotation model class with a validation error message. Then, add the @bindChecked property and assign the degree field from the annotation class. At last, I include the validation message tag and map the field degree from the Annotation class. Checking now, when I select the UG course, the validation message is shown. In this video, I have shown you how to work with native events and model binding in the checkbox and radio button components. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can look into obtaining a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.